Shalom bracha, good morning, welcome to our Inyani Diyom Hashir. Here we are, approaching Parshas Chayesara, holding by the end of the week, let's turn with Siyata Nishmaya, towards the end of this week's Parsha. We know it's all about Chayesara, it's all about the lives of Sarah, one of the few Parshios in the Chamisho Chumshei Torah named for an individual, not really Stam named for Sarah, named for Chayesara, and then of course we had Noach earlier in Sefer Bereishis, we'll have Yisro and Sefer Shemos, and then nothing in Vayikra, we'll move on to Bamidbar, and there we'll encounter Parshas Korach, Parshas Balak, Parshas Pinchas. Interessant. But Lamaisa, this Parsha is all about Sarah, and yet it's not really all about Sarah. After all, she is not even alive throughout the pages of this week's Parsha, but through the pursuit, the search for a suitable successor to Sarah Imenu in the matriarchal line, we get glimpses into her greatness, we get a better comprehension and understanding of the godless, the profundity of the true greatness of what Sarah Imenu was all about, and how Rivka Vayeviyah Ha'ola Sarah Imo, as we discussed earlier this week, Perch of Dalet Pasuk Samazayin, and Vehi Sarah Imo, Rashi told us it's Keilu, she took over for Sarah. We see the Gevaldik Chesed, the Gevaldik Tznius, unbelievable mindless of the most HaKadoshos. But the Parsha is not done. After Yitzchak finally has Rivka by his side, since, and the post can talk about this, you have to take care of marrying off your children before you marry off yourself in certain cases. Again, it's a whole big deal, a whole big discussion in that regard. But Lamaisa, at the end of the Parsha, in the sixth Aliyah, Vayosef Avram Yikach Ish Shma Keturah, and they have children together, and then we get to the end of the sixth Aliyah. And what do we read? And then Avram Vinu dies. Vayamas Avram is Seva Tova Zokain Visaveya. Seva Tova Saveya. It's Gavaldik. He already set everything into motion. Interestingly enough, Avram Avinu did not say another word on the Torah's pages after he instructs and makes Eliezer Eved Avram swear. By the way, Eliezer's name is also not even mentioned. He's Eved Avram in this week's Parsha. Avram Avinu has his last thing to say in the world stage, and that is, Eliezer, this is your Shlichus. I want you to go and find a suitable wife for my son Yitzchak. Avram Avinu takes care of that. It's Kilu, his job is done. No more speaking parts on the pages. His job is done. Gevaldik. Look what he accomplished throughout his lifetime. Now he has set Yitzchak and Rivka into motion to take over where he and Sarah Imenu left off. He gets married again, has some more children, and then what? And then he passes away. He is a Zokin. He is Saveya. Avayeyase Felama. Vayikro so Yitzchak Yishmo Marasamach Peila. Hasoda Sherkon Avram Eishon Echesham Akubar Avram. There Avram and Marasamach Peila was buried with Sarah and Sarah his wife. And of course the question, the Medrash and all this foreign poetry, well, we know Sarah was buried there. We had the whole beginning of the Parsha. Purchasing the Soda, the Machpelah, the Ma'ora, everything was already taken care of. Sarah was buried. Why the need to repeat? Oh, by the way, Shama Kuba Abraham, this Sarah Ishto together with Sarah. So again, you could answer Pashup Shot. It's just recounting, telling us that he was placed alongside Sarah Ishto, together with Sarah, his wife. And again, Nafuki, there's no Hagar, there's no Keturah, this is Avram and Sarah Ishto, that's his wife. They're a team, they're there in Maras Machpelah. But the Medrash Rabbah does ask the Kasha, if we're talking about Kvuras Avram, why the need to mention the Kvura of Sarah as well? So in the Otzer Plos HaTorah Gevaldik HaSefer, citing the Medrash, says a Dover Niflamot. The Pasuk is coming to teach us that anyone who is Goma Chesed, you did a Maisa Chesed Cholames by engaging in the process of Kvura, burying Sarah Imenu, writes the Medrash, those individuals who were involved in the Levaya and the Kvura of Sarah Imenu was Zocha Tarichas Yomim. Now keep in mind, the Rosh would talk about Avram and Sarah, we know that he was 10 years older, after all he was 100, and when Yitzhak was born, Sarah was 90. They got married. He was 25. She was 15. We have in the various Midrashim in the Sefer Yemos Olam, many different forms talking about it. See, he was 10 years old, though. Sarah dies at 127. He was clearly 137. You make the Cheshbon, 38 years. Avram Avinu lived another 38 years after the tragic demise of his beloved wife, Sarah Imenu. But writes the Medrash Adover Nifla, anyone who partook in the Chesed Shalemes in burying Sarah Imenu, they did not die in the ensuing 38 years. Nobody died. Why? He was zeicha in that first act of bearing sarah chesed shalemes. Abishter says, yes, keren kayemes olam haba, but you're going to get ocha perasim yolam hazan, the mission of pay aleph aleph. You're going to get schar. You're going to enjoy reward in this world as well. None of those individuals died in the span of the 38 ensuing years so that they could be zeicha midakinimita to now also partake in the chesed shalemes of bearing Avram Avinu together with Sarah Ishto, Givaldik Mamela, they were able to do chesed not only with Sarah, but with Avram Avinu as well. And that's why writes the Medrash, Shama Kubar Avram, the Sarah Ishto, the same people who had buried Sarah Ishto, were now burying Avram as well. That's the chesed, the Mina Kadegamita, Givaldik. So Avram Avinu has the Levaya, who's involved in the Levaya, as the Torah says, Yitzhak and Yishmon came to bury, and like the Medrash adds on, together with all those who were involved in the Kivura of Sarimeno as well. And then we turn our attention to a Gemara in the fifth parak above Abasra, the bottom of Daf Tzadi Aleph Amud Aleph. And the Gemara just told us about the mother of Avraham Avinu, Amaslei Bas Karnavo. Great trivia questions here, of course, in the Gemara. And then the Gemara says as follows at the bottom of the Yamad. Ve'amar Abchana Barava, Abarava Amarav. It's said over in the name of Rav. Oso Hayom Sheniftar Avraham Avinu Min Olam. On that very day that Avraham Avinu was Niftar Min Olam, that he passed away, that he left this world, Amdu Kol Gedolei Umas Olam Bishura, all the great leaders of all the nations of the world stood up in a line, V'amru, and they said, Oilo Li Olam Sha'avan Manhigo, woe is to the world that lost its manig, its leader, the one who gave its direction, V'oilo L'sfina Sha'avan Kvarnita, and woe is to the ship that lost its captain. Rashi says, Hamolach HaSfina, the captain, the one who is directing the ship. Woe is to the ship that now lost its captain. Of course, this is a nusach that's borrowed whenever we lose Gedolei Yisrael. And you go through the streets of Meyasharm Gula Vachulei Ayla, and the Ayla'm Sha'avod Manhigo, Ayla L'Sfina, Sha'avod Kivarnita. And of course, the question that immediately beckons our scrutiny is why the redundancy? L'chaira, you're telling us what? Woe is to the world. We lost the Gol Hador. We lost the one who was the Manig. The Tzadik Ador was leading the whole world. We lost him. What's the Hosaf of Ayla L'Sfina, Sha'avod Kvarnita? Why have to make two different descriptive terms? Why the need for both ideas presented in this mini hesped for Avraham Avinu? So in the Sefer Kemotzei Sholo Rav, towards the end of the parsha, Sir Rabinowitz brings a Gevaldiga of Rav Avraham, the Amor Tzedek of Bereshdiv. So, Rav Rosenthal, I'm sorry, the author of Kemotzei Sholo Rav, he cites from the Sefer Derech Tomim on Hilchos Techumen. So he asks this kashus, he says, Avada, they are two separate kavanas. What were their kavanas? Kavana number one was, we lost the manig. What's the manig? Someone who was manig, Anshe Dora V'doeg Shalayasish Thereo Avla Binyanim Shebeneim Hanogim Lamamin. We need a leader who's going to make sure that society behaves, that's going to direct and coach and lead society to make sure that what Olam Kimanoga, knowing the world can continue to exist. All right, we want to be order and law in society. The manig is the one who tells us, Rabbi Sai, you have to have Bein Odom L'Chavero, you have to keep society going. That's a manig. You have to make sure that everyone is together. Perhaps parenthetically, the same way, many Sfarim explain why Nimrod, Tower of Babel, Ir HaMigdal, why did they get to be merely dispersed while the Dor HaMabul was completely eradicated, totally destroyed, because there it was a kilkul and Beinonim Lechavero society falls apart, Dor HaMabul, that's Gezel, that's Chamas, that's Hashchasa, promiscuity, depravity, and they fall apart. Nimrod, at least, what? They had Achdus, we even find the word, the Reyeu, they had Achdus, they worked together, they were building together, horizontally, vertically, the ear, the Migdal, the city, the tower, they were working together. But in line with this, what? It's very good. Nimrod, they had a leader. Tahino, they had a monic. Dora Mabul did not have a monic. Maybe Noah should have stepped up to the plate, and we find in various farm that he was criticized. Kimei Noah Zosli, the Zohar Parshas Noach. He didn't step up to the plate to be the monic. At least Nimrod was the monic of the people. So the Melech is backwards, Osios, Mem, Lam, and Chav, backwards, Kulam. The Melech is called the Achad Am, he's Ma'achid the Am. He's the Levi. The Rambam uses that terminology, Nochas Melochim. at the end of the Mishnah Torah, he is the Lev Ha'am. He is Ma'achi the Am. At least when they are Nimrod, the leader, can put people together. So that's a manig. A manig is people, society, stay together, behave, have law and order, and make sure you have midos, etc. Aye, but what's the Sfina? The Sfina is the other Nakuda of Avraham Avinu, was leading Anshei Dora Machnisim Tachas Kanfei Ashchina. What's that idea? When you're in the turbulent sea of life and you don't know where you're going, you can have everybody on a cruise ship and they're getting along. They're dancing together. They're eating together. They're in the restaurants together. They're getting along. They have their bingo, their activities on the cruise ships, whatever they're doing, games, they can all be together. But if there's no captain piloting the ship, if there's no one steering the wheel of the ship, then you're lost. You're lost in the sea of life and the turbulent waters that are raging around you. There's no direction. Amela, that's Avraham Avinu's second Nakuda, that he's the Kvarnit, he's the captain of the ship that's leading the world, all of society, just like all society was in the Teva. So to Kila, you have the world, everyone can be together, but which direction is the world going in? That's steering the ship in the turbulent seas, waters. There's no direction. You get lost at sea, forget it, then all is forlorn, all is gone. But what? You have someone steering the ship, and the Chara, we can add on to that, that it's very good. When you have a manik, everybody knows the manik. We hear from the manik, whether it's media, whether it's print media, everybody hears about the manik. We know our manik, we talk about the presidents, we talk about the Lahabdel Afi Abdullah Sagadol Yisol, our manhige hador, they're our Eine Haida Shlach, Tesvav Chavdala, they're leading the world. How many people? I've never been on a cruise ship, I don't have any cheshik, any time to be on a cruise ship, but you don't even know the captain, so you don't see the captain. Think about an airplane. When was the last time you ever went and really met who the, you don't know who's piloting the airplane, you don't know the pilot, you might not have seen him, you don't know what he looks like, there's no conversation with him. So to you on a ship, you have no shaykhus them. Aye, but what is he doing? He's taking everybody, you're conversing, whether in coach or business, you're conversing with everybody. Aye, but there's a guy hidden behind the curtain, no shaykhus, he's not Ma'uriv and Mabrius, but he's steering everyone together in the right direction. That's what the pilot of the plane does, and that's what the captain steering the ship does, takes everyone united as one and brings them in the right direction. Ad kan the derech tamim hilchus tuchumen. That's how he answers the lashon above a masur tzadi aleph amen aleph. That's why there are two ideas. One is Avraham Avinu is the manik who kept society together and gave guidance how to have law and order and establish a systematic framework of people getting along with achnasas orchem and gemilas chasodim. And then there's the captain of the ship who is not actively involved with the people, but what he's leading everybody. So ad kan derech tamim lafini is daiti. Now let's make an additional diuk in the Gemara. If we peer a little bit more closely. Interesting. What was the terminology? Amdu ko gedolei umas olam. So we're talking about all the great leaders of what? We're not talking about the followers of Avraham Avinu. We're talking about gedolei umas olam. We're talking about the kings, the leaders of the whole world. They stood up a shura. Aviyamra, what did they say? What was to the world? Now why what was to the world? If you're going to go in and tell me a monarch, so tell me what was to the a wagon that doesn't have a driver. Woe is to the car that doesn't have the driver. Over here, it's woe is to the world that lost its manik. And then it's woe is to the ship that lost its captain. So one is the world and one is the ship. Why? Like the Derech Tamim, it's very geschmack. And the end of the day, the world did not go after the Ribono Shel Olam. The Gedolei Umas Olam, they still stayed with their Avodah Zarah. Avimelech was still Avimelech, and Paro was still Paro. And all those people with whom he interacted, they were all impressed by him. But Lamaisa, Lamaisa, they never joined his ship. They were never on his ship. They were going in their own direction after their false foreign gods. But what? But they were influenced by the Midos. You see, Avimelech, Paro, they're influenced by his Hanhoga, by the Midos. Even in Ephron HaRosha, the nefarious Ephron. What is he called? The Nasi Elokim. They knew him as a Nasi Elokim. They're going to stay Nasi Haaretz, Ches, V'chulei. They're going to be Mushka Shakua, mired, engrossed, Legamri, and Atzius, and and Gashmius and the mundane, the material, and the physical. But they appreciated, they had an interaction with Avraham Avinu. Shmo Holech Lafonov, his reputation was promulgated worldwide. Everybody knew him. The Baal Chesed par excellence. He didn't have to be Jewish. Everybody knew. Look, if it's on the page of the Torah, that means by definition it's spread. He davened for Sodom to save Rishoyim. He does Hachnosis Archim for Arabs. Arabs, angels, and Chule. And the end of the day, Avraham Avinu took the world Chesed. He took the world to law and order. It was Gevaldik. So then, I'm the Gedolim Asulam Ashura. They stood up in the Shura and they said, what? You're right. We're not going after God, the Jewish God. his reintroduction of monotheism to the world. But you know what? We're going to say two things. Number one is Eilu the Olam, because this affects us as well. Woe is to the entirety of the world that lost its monarch. He was also our monarch. They recognize the beginning of Chai Sori. He's the Nasi Elokim. He is the Nasi. The Hainu, he's teaching us what it means to live as Selim Elokim, is what it means to live with a piece of the divine in you, and how to react, how to speak to people, how he carried himself vis-a-vis Aparo and Avimelech and Ephraim and Arosha. He told the world, woe is to the world, we lost the monarch. Like the Derech Talmud's Geshmak. What's the monarch? The one who is Bechina the Melech, the one who's monarch, he's the one keeping us going. And who understood that better than Abraham Avinu, who sacrificed so much of his learning just to go ahead and unite the people and to keep everybody together. That is shining light, his prime example, the paradigmatic figure of what the Yish Chesed was all about. Rav Hirsch even says when he davened on behalf of Sodom, what's this superfluous mention of Besoch? Zalman Sorotskin is a beautiful approach and is a Znaim Lutaro. But writes of Shamsh of Hirsch, Besoch Yer, Abram of Sin. I know you can't have Stam at Tzadik say people who's just in his tyrant filling his Dalai Lamas, but maybe that's Tzadik and Besoch Yer, Besoch Ami Anochi Yosheves, as we had recently in Naftaira. Tahaina, who's Mu'urvim Abrius, that's Abramino, is the classic quintessential example. His whole life is more of a Marius. He's Besoch Amishamelo when he dies. Kishanif Abram Avinu Manolam. Amduko Gedole Omasola Beshura. And what did they say? Ayla the Olam, because we all feel the magnitude of this loss. The whole world is now missing its Manig. Manig highlights what? The one who keeps us together, who keeps us unified, who preserves law and order, perpetuates society. Then what? To notice how? Then they don't say Ayla the Olam, they lost the captain of the ship. They could have said, Ayla the Olam, Sha'avad the Olam Hasfina Kvarnita, or Avad Kvarnita. I don't know, what are they saying? We're not on his boat, we're not in his ship. He's got his own ship. He's in his own waters, in the waters of God. Elohim, Kel Hayam, the seas of the world. Yes, Abram Avinu is out there in the raging turbulent waters. We're happy on land. We're happy in Mitzrayim. We're happy in our own places. We got everything going for us. He took his people out on a ship and he's steering them. We're not going where he's going, but you know what? He's pretty impressive. You know what? Look at how he lives his life. So we have our foreign gods, our Avodah Zarah. You can't say, Ayla Leolam, like the Derech Tamim. Asfarnita is the one who what? Who with this highlights the aspect of Avram that's not actively now involved in reinforcing and enhancing the midas of Inam L'Chaveru. This is taking everyone, Bein Adam L'Mokam, and now attaching them to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Memela, they couldn't say Oilo the Olam, they could only say Oilo L'Sfina, the Hainu. Woe is to that ship, that large ship, Nevashashashashashu B'choran, Avram's ship that he took out, surrounded by the raging waters. Who's steering it? Avram Vino has a second role, a dual role, and that is what, like the captain of the ship, you don't interact with him, you're not speaking with him. You don't necessarily even know what he looks like, and you certainly don't know his name. He's the pilot sitting behind in a separate compartment. He's upstairs in the upper deck in his little compartment. He's leading the ship. He's taking all society, and he's telling you which direction to go in. Out in the open waters when you could easily drown and easily get inundated and swallowed up, he's the one giving the world a direction. What? Not to all of us. We're Gedolei Umos Olam. We're not listening to, but woe was to his Sfina and all his people and all his Nefeshos B'chorin, Shabidu L'Araisa. Woe was to that ship and Memela. We answered our questions. That's the Galus of Abram Avinu. And now, after we talked about Rav David Feinstein's Atzal, one of the Gedolei Yisrael, let's also make mention we lost a great human being. We lost a great rabbi, Rabbi Lord Jonathan Sacks, Zechona Levracha. What a profound intellectual mind who changed so many lives the world over. What an impact that he left over decades. Rachmona Litzlan, we're losing so many great individuals as a great piece in his own Kabbalah. Into conversation back in Parshas Lech Lecha, a new kind of hero. And he says, what's the galus of Abram Avinu? He doesn't fit that image of the Hollywood, the media hero, the mighty muscles changing the world, all the war. What do we know about him? What is it? It's not the conventional religious hero. It's what? He's a man of exemplary virtue, welcomes strangers, gives them food. He teaches society how to be a moral and ethical person, how to be caring and loving and concerned about society. That's what? That's the type of hero that is the Gedolei Umos Olam can recognize as well. Caring about everyone, Jew and non-Jews alike, Rav Yaakov Emden and Ovis Aleph Beis. Oivis Abrius in Makarv in the Torah. It's not Oivis Yisrael, right? Rav Yaakov Emden. Oivis Abrius is an all-encompassing term. Love everybody, the Jews, the non-Jews. Somebody like Rabbi Sacks had such a powerful influence on Jews, on non-Jews, the world over in England, in the United States. Such an impact over decades through his oral masterful oratory speeches and lectures, coupled with his fantastic, influential writings. A great person we lost, Rabbi Sacks, Zechonah Livracha, person who writes about what the godless of Avraham Avinu is: live a moral, ethical life, show the world what a Jew could be. Yuma Pevava Manalef, hold that Jew, that Yid on a pedestal. Look what Avraham Avinu, we could all be like that as well. Abaisai, we lost an Avraham Avinu. We lost the Malik of the world that everybody in the world, the Gedolei Yom HaSolem, recognized. And then what? And his ship, his own ship of Klai Yisrael, of his followers, as what? Lost its captain. Ay, Rabaisai, we need more leaders. We need Gedolei Yisrael. Avish don't have Rachmanis on us. Bring us Gedolei Yisrael to this Dar Yosem. Bring us Mashiach Tzidkenu to be reunited with Yemos Mashiach and Tchiyas Amesim with these Gedolei Yisrael. B'meirah v'yameinu. Amen v'yameinu. Have a gevaldige day and a geshmak Shabbos Kodesh.